I hope all is well for you. Today we will see what is the classiest way to respond when meeting a celebrity. Welcome to the question answer channel, the channel where you will find the answer to everything. Thanks to Allaya Cooks-Campbell, Christine Thompson, Ben Wright and Shelley Stewart for sharing their views on this question. Let's go for Allaya Cooks-Campbell's first answer.
My husband and I saw Kevin Hart and a group of his friends walk into a popular restaurant near a comedy club in NYC. As New Yorkers, we generally leave celebrities alone, but my husband is a mega, mega fan. We approached them after a few minutes and asked politely for a photo. He agreed, he's super nice, and asked if it was okay if he got something to eat first. We said no worries, we were waiting on our food too. He didn't really seem in a rush, so after a while, we ate at our table, talked, hung out with our friends, we got up to head out. At that point he walked over to take the photo. He had just done his first Madison Square Garden special, and it was evident in the recording how much that meant to him. So I leaned in and said, "Congrats on the garden, man. That's huge." His face lit up and he seemed genuinely happy as he thanked me. His girlfriend was super sweet and took the photo for us. I guess same advice as everyone else. Be gracious and treat them like a human being. Celebrities want to eat, too.
The next answer is from Christine Thompson.
This is a story about a reversal. A star spotting my mom. Back in the 80s, my mother traveled a lot for her job. While at the Atlanta airport, she was trying to board her flight, but there was a huge mass of people. Flashes from cameras. Just a big melee. Mom is politely pushing her way through the masses when someone takes her by the arm, smiles at her and walks her to the boarding ramp. Mom just thanks them, gets on the plane and settles in. Looking toward first class, she notices that there are instruments in cases. Long-haired guys, girls, just crowded again. Fast forward. About a week later, again she is at ATL and again masses of people while she is trying to get off the plane. All of a sudden she hears someone shouting, "Dragon Nail Lady! Dragon Nail Lady!" And to her surprise the sea of people split. Again this long-haired guy comes forward grinning at her and a young lady trailing behind him. They along with more long-haired guys help Mom out of the throng of people. During the few moments he explained, "I remember you from a week or so ago. Your nails? Sorry for all this crazy." And with that, she was on her way to baggage claim. My mom wore fake nails painted deep red. Shakes her head. So she gets home and later asks me about a band. "Christine, who is that band with the boys with long hair? And really polite and sweet." I blink at her. Long hair guys in a band and this is the 80s. "Really? Mom? Longed band members that are polite and sweet? I don't know. Van Halen." First name that came out of my mouth. "That's them." And she proceeds to tell me the story. I sat there in shock. Now as any teenage girl, I immediately asked if she got their autographs. Of course she didn't. So then I asked her if she spoke to Valerie. She gave me a puzzled look and I had to remind her that Eddie Van Halen was married to Valerie Bertinelli, whom Mom adores and thinks is so cute. Oh, that was her. I didn't recognize her, but she didn't speak much. So that is my story of how a famous person approached my mom.
The following answer is from Ben Wright.
As a US-based company, you have a few options when looking to hire foreigners based in a different country. If you have already found the employees you want to hire, you can hire them as contractors, which a lot of companies tend to do but can present compliance and legal issues down the road. There are many country-specific laws and regulations that may cause you to be out of compliance. For example, depending on the country and their local laws, your contract may have to be written in a certain language. Or, you can hire them as employees using a global employer of record, EOR. Which is the least risky option and best way to hire remote international employees in terms of legality and cost. A global EOR partner will handle the payroll, benefits, and compliance issues for your international workforce while you manage their day-to-day duties.
The next answer is from Shelley Stewart.
I was the next person in line at PetSmart, laden down with bags of live squirming fish, yawning, bored when I noticed a thin woman dressed in a man's tight-fitted grey suit with yellow narrow stripes. She turned to look at the cashier and glanced at me. It was Diane Keaton. She didn't look like this though, she looked exhausted. She was pulling a big flat cart piled up with immense bags of dog food. Our eyes met. I got the vibe that she didn't want a gushing fan asking for an autograph. We nodded at each other, she winked and whispered thanks, next thing I knew there was a crowd around her asking her questions and for autographs. We nodded at each other as I coolly sauntered past the crowd. I was glad I read her signals. She was exhausted and seemed stressed. Wow, Diane Keaton nodded at me. I felt so cool.
This is the end of the video. I hope you have more answers. If you found the answer you were looking for, please leave a like and subscribe. It would help us a lot. This is now the end of this video. Remember to leave a comment to tell us if these answers resonate with you. Bye and see you soon.